that the biodiversity there is in the southeast corner of the archipelago is quite intact, and that there's amazing, absolutely amazing ecosystems to see and explore. Once we combined that information with our satellite data, we started to see that other parts of that region in the South China Sea are not doing so well.
And how much loss of reef cover did you discover?
Well, using the combination of diving and satellite data, we assessed pretty much all of the atolls that are found in the South China Sea, the atolls that are currently occupied by one nation or another. And we found up to a 70% decrease in coral reef ecosystem presence in some of these atolls that have been massively converted into military bases. So it's a range of conditions from highly pristine, those are the areas that are still untouched or relatively much less impact, all the way to those that are have been radically converted to military bases. Those have seen big losses in coral reef ecology and coral reef systems.
Yeah, as you discovered, a 70% reduction in reef cover. That's quite significant. Now, these atolls are occupied by China as well as Malaysia, Vietnam, Philippines. Is China making the most negative ecological impact here?
Yeah, on a scale of who's doing the converting and who's destroying reef, China is in the lead in the sense of they are building the fastest and they are converting these atolls, which is a process where they go and they literally dredge up the coral itself and fold it into the center part of the atoll as a kind of a foundation, and then they add to it and ultimately build runways and infrastructure. And that obviously destroys the coral reef, and along with it, we're seeing millions and millions of individual creatures being lost in that process.
And have you shared your research with the Chinese and other nations who are involved in the South China Sea so they can understand the ecological impact of their outpost building there?
The process we typically go through is through our scientific community, and right now we published a paper on what we found. We're communicating that information to other scientists, including to scientists in China and the other countries that are interested in and claimants of that part of the South China Sea. We're sharing the biodiversity knowledge that we're gaining, and we're building up the scientific basis for making the case even more strongly that this is a special region, this is an opportunity for people to come together to have on the table the issue of conservation and protection of this unique biodiversity hotspot.
And a final question for you. You know, China is undeterred. It continues to build military outposts and even man-made islands in the South China Sea. So what hope is there for the coral reefs and for the biodiversity of the South China Sea?
Well, in the Spratly Islands, which is the archipelago in the South China Sea that we're talking about, you know, out of about 100 atolls and reef systems that are part of this archipelago, about 15 have been deeply impacted so far, so 15% or so. So the news can be good if we turn this around before more reefs and atolls are converted.